strap yourself in for a great high school football game. Irmo coming down to the beach to take on the Myrtle Beach Seahawks. It got started by an eye-popping field goal from Max Huggins. This one was 47 yards. It would have been good maybe from 57 as the Seahawks jump out in front 3-0. Then Myrtle Beach going to the air. Tyler Keene, DeShawn Michael Orcutt. What a great grab. The Seahawks have a 9-0 advantage. Orcutt would leave the game with a mild concussion. After Myrtle Beach took a 12-0 lead, Irmo seized the momentum for the rest of the half. This, a run by Bryce Fashaw into the zone, and at the half, the Yellow Jackets took a 14-12 advantage. And it looked as if Irmo was going to pull away in this one. They scored a pair of third-quarter touchdowns, including this double pass. Trey Suber to Andre Jameson makes it 27-12 midway through the third. But here come the Seahawks with a vengeance. Down by 8, Keene fires to Terrell Harrell. He's in the zone. Myrtle Beach can't convert the two-point conversion. It's a 27-25 game. Then late in the fourth quarter, Irmo in punt formation and in special teams delivery. O.T. Thomas scoops it up and takes the nasty plunge into the end zone. That is your game winner. Myrtle Beach roars from behind. 21 unanswered points, 33-27. The Seahawks roar back to beat Irmo.
It shows that we know how to fight. We know how to handle adversity together. And you know, we're a team, baby, and we're going to always ride together.
Felt great. We did this as a team, man. It's just awesome. The fans were loud. Our team came together, fought through adversity. That's the only thing we did, just fought through adversity and came back.
Irmo is a great football team. My hat's off to them. We're just excited to get a W. Went a great block down there to get us a win. I mean, I'm ecstatic right now. Great job by our kids.
When Irmo took that 27-12 lead in the third quarter, a lot of people thought maybe this was the end of the reign of Myrtle Beach as a state power. But reports of the Seahawks' demise were certainly premature. What's even more impressive is the fact that Myrtle Beach got it done without a number of key players, including Chocolate Wilson, due to injuries. Myrtle Beach will take this win and try and carry the momentum for the rest of 2012. At Doug Shaw Memorial Stadium, I'm Rich Krampanis, News Channel 15 Sports.